With us.
Ephesians 2, 4 through 7. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace and kindness towards us in Jesus Christ.
Sing, oh precious.
Oh precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. I am washed, I am washed, I am drenched in love.
All souls,
all souls atoned by the blood of the Lamb. I'm not a slave to what once held me. How beautiful that cleansing flood. I am washed, I am washed, I am drenched in love.
Oh, precious is
once shackled me. How infinite that grace divine. I am free, I am free, I am a child of God.
Wanting some.
hallelujah together.
Hallelujah, death is undone. Hallelujah, Jesus has won. Hallelujah. Oh, in Jesus, hallelujah. Death is undone, hallelujah. Jesus has won, hallelujah. We overcome, oh, in Jesus. Oh, in Jesus, hallelujah. Death is undone, hallelujah. Jesus has won, hallelujah. We overcome, oh, your voice and sing that Christ is King, for Jesus is alive. Let there be dancing in the darkness, and let our song break through the night. Lift your voice and sing that Christ is King, for Jesus is alive. Lift your voice and sing that Christ is King, for Jesus is alive.
Oh, let's pray together. God, you are alive, and you are Lord of our hearts. God, we thank you for bringing us here. Lord, give us eyes to see and ears to hear what you are speaking to us. Lord, let us leave changed by the gospel. Let us transform Hope College with the gospel. In your name we pray. Amen.
Peace of Christ be with you. We've got some guests here. We've got some prospective students. We want to welcome you to Hope. Yes. I got grandparents in the front row, Steve and Bonnie. Welcome them. Awesome. A couple notices before we get rolling. Today's Friday. Happy Friday. We got Front Porch Friday, sponsored by our own beloved Student Development. And they have got, and they've got vintage Hope College Student Development swag. You cannot get this on the internet. We got cups. We got t-shirts. We got magnets. If you want some original, old school, vintage gear, come on over to Front Porch Friday. Sunday night, we got the gathering. We're going to be right here asking the question, what do Christians believe? And why does it matter? One quick comment to freshmen. This is coming out of some pastoral conversations I've had this week. I need you to respect and honor the October rule. Okay? I'm having a couple of conversations. Now, if you're unclear, the October rule is just a pastoral suggestion that don't start dating, don't jump into a relationship until October. You're in a major life transition, and in my experience, a major life transition is not the time to jump into a complex relationship. Amen? Because, and you seniors can testify, because you're going to get to fourth year knowledge, and you're going to say, oh, ooh, ow, I should not have done that. Help me help you. Honor the October rule. Okay, the word of the Lord today comes from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 7, verses 17. Hear the word of the Lord from the book we love, the bush that burns and is never consumed. When he had left the crowd and entered the house, the disciples asked him about the parable. And he said to them, do you also fail to understand? Do you not see that what comes from the outside cannot defile? Because it does not go into the heart, but into the stomach, and then goes into the sewer. Thus he declared all food clean. And he said, it's what comes out of a person that defiles them. For it's from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come. Sexual immorality, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, debauchery, envy, slander, pride, folly, for all these evil things come from within, and they are what defile a person. This is the word of the Lord. Have you ever been with someone, and you've been talking, and they hear you, but they don't hear you? Yeah? How's that feel? You've been sharing your heart. You've been trying to say something true, and they hear you, but they don't hear you. They don't get it. They're not understanding. They're not comprehending what you're actually trying to say. Jesus is in this situation. He's with his disciples, these disciples that he himself has called, these disciples that he's traveling with. He eats with them. They sleep in the same vicinity. They joke together. They argue together. They're with each other all the time, and they bear witness to Jesus' teaching. They hear him, but they don't hear him. And so Jesus asked this question. The question I want to pose for us today and spend some time with is, do you also fail to understand? In other words, don't you get it? Don't you see what I'm trying to get at? Now, the context of this is that Jesus has talked about food. Food that, for some people think, is what defiles you. And Jesus is poking at something fundamental to his teaching. Fundamental to everything that Jesus' wisdom offers humanity. Now, Jesus is Jewish, and he's speaking within a Jewish context. And within that, the law is taken very seriously, so seriously that they develop what they call the fence. There is the law, but then you set up other laws so that you protect yourself from never even getting near breaking the law. And then that fence becomes a kind of tradition. A tradition that kind of settles in to its own kind of law. The tradition that meant to serve the commandment actually starts to break the commandment after a time because people are so fussy about doing what is perceived to be the right thing, right? So a tradition is meant to be a servant, not a master. The good part of a tradition or a law like that is that it can be a guide, a guardrail. It can be a servant for us. But when it becomes a master, it starts to interrupt actually what was originally intended. And that's what Jesus' teaching is all about. Because Jesus is the author of all humanity. All things came into being through him. And so he knows something fundamental about each one of us, about human nature. A nature, by the way, that he shares. He knows that the heart is prone to wander. He knows, channeling Jeremiah, that the heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can understand it? And so Jesus' teaching is always trying to get underneath of that tradition, of that service. He'll say things like, you have heard it was said to those of ancient times, you shall not murder, but I say to you that if you are angry with a brother or sister, you are liable to judgment. If you insult a brother or sister, you'll be liable to the council. If you say you fool, you'll be liable to the hell of fire. He's trying to get in it. It's not that you murdered, but it starts deeper in your heart. You've heard it was said you shall not commit adultery, but I say to you that anyone who looks at a woman with lust or a man has already committed adultery with his or her heart. It's not the adultery begins someplace else. Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them. So whenever you give alms, do not be like the hypocrites who love to stand in the synagogues in the street corners sounding a trumpet before them so that they'll be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward, but when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing so that your alms may be done in secret. See, God doesn't like using him for our perceptions, playing a religious game. And Jesus' teaching is always poking at that. And in this context, they're wondering, hey, I thought that this food, if we ate it, it would defile us. And Jesus tells us the fundamental truth, right? That it's not the food that defiles. What defiles us comes somewhere deeper within us, within our human heart. You've heard this, right? Like, trust your heart. That is not Jesus' teaching. You be you. You just go with it. It'll be fine. That's not Christian teaching. Because he knows that our hearts can be manipulated. Self-deception is the easiest thing. What Jesus is saying is, let your heart be guided by the word of God. We have to discern. Don't you understand this, says Jesus. Do you, are you failing to get what I say? You're with me all the time. You're hearing me, but you haven't heard me. And so I want to pose that question to us. Do you also fail to understand? G.K. Chesterton once was asked, "What's the problem with humanity?" And he answered, "I am." Because he knows, as Alexander Solzhenitsyn said, that the line of good and evil runs through us all. He knows that the problem begins in here, in each of us. And not using faith or religion or chapel to create this false perception, Jesus wants to go right to who we are, to our hearts, to our heart. And so we don't want to put our trust and worry about the things that we're trying to make us look good. Jesus is saying, I want you to have a heart that is good. And that requires all of us. I'm told today is fall crawl, is that right? Yeah. Oh, preacher just said something. And I'm told on fall crawl, let's just say there's a lot of punch that's served. And when a lot of punch is served, sometimes throughout, if it starts early and goes late, people start making bad decisions. Decisions that they regret. When a lot of punch is served, there can be sexual assaults. Things are said that you didn't want to say. Things are done that you don't want to do. And my point here is, it's not about the punch. That's not what defiles us. It's about what's in here. It's about what's in our heart. And that's what Jesus is asking us to pay attention to. Which is why the psalmist cries out, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me." Because Jesus' questions, "Do you not understand?" is actually an invitation. It's an invitation to have a beautiful soul. It's an invitation to say, "I want what's best for you. Listen to what I have to say. Don't believe in the false currency that these other things are going to satisfy you. Let my word be your guide. Let it shepherd your heart. And you will find joy. You will find peace. You will find all the fruit of the Spirit growing off the limbs of your life. And let it begin today. God, create in me a clean heart. Today and this afternoon and tonight, help me to love you with all of my heart, mind, soul, and strength." Because God, we know that it's not the external things, it's the things in us, in all of us. And we all share that, which is why we all need God's grace. We're in this together, amen? Let's love each other well. I love you. Go in peace. Have a great Friday. See you soon.